Cotton is one of the most essential textile fibers in the world. It is used in 70% of clothing, with global production exceeding 25 million tons annually. But how is cotton transformed into clothing? In this video, we'll explore the processing of cotton at the largest clothes manufacturing plant in the United States. The global fashion industry is a powerhouse, generating over $1 trillion annually. While fashion trends may come and go, this one fiber consistently stands the test of time. In downtown Los Angeles stands North America's largest clothing manufacturing factory, where an impressive 53 million garments are produced annually. To meet this immense demand, a vast amount of thread is sourced from the cotton belt in North Carolina. Cotton, a crop with a history spanning over 5,000 years, requires meticulous preparation before planting. The soil is expertly plowed to loosen it and remove weeds, creating an ideal seedbed and promoting robust root growth. The seeds are carefully planted in rows with precise spacing between each seed, ensuring that each plant has ample room to grow and access enough sunlight. The seeds are buried at a specific depth in the soil, which aids in germination and supports healthy plant development. Planting occurs in the spring, taking advantage of the warm temperatures and longer daylight hours to encourage rapid growth. Flowering typically happens a few weeks after planting, once the cotton plants have reached the right level of maturity. Cotton flowers, which are white, emerge at the ends of the branches. It takes about 5 months for cotton to grow from seed to a fully mature plant. Inside the pods, cotton fibers begin to form as elongated cells that gradually accumulate layers of cellulose, the primary substance in cotton fibers. Cotton harvesting is commonly done with mechanical harvesters specifically designed for this purpose. These machines cut the plants and collect the mature pods. Modern machinery is efficient and fast, allowing for a quick harvest and reducing labor costs. The cotton harvester is an amazing invention that revolutionized the cotton industry when the first machines had commercial success after World War II. Before the invention of the cotton harvester, all cotton was harvested by hand. Today, a single cotton harvester can collect as much cotton in one day as over 250 workers. As the drums spin, the spiked hooks pass through the cotton plant, catching the cotton lint and pulling it from the husk. The cotton harvester has an onboard fan that blows air at high speed through the suction doors, aiding in the collection process. Once harvested, the cotton is collected in containers at the back of the harvesters. When these containers are full, the cotton is loaded for further processing. Once a significant amount of cotton has been harvested, it is packed into large bales for easy transportation and storage before being sent to processing facilities. These bales are transported to cotton ginning machines, specialized facilities that separate cotton fibers from seeds and other impurities. Upon arrival at the processing plant, the cotton undergoes initial cleaning to remove sticks, burrs, and any remaining debris and seeds. The cotton seed falls onto a conveyor belt leading to a gin machine, which uses a combination of rollers and blades to separate the fibers from the seeds. The machine mixes the cotton seed with hot air, evaporating moisture and facilitating cleaning. During the ginning process, impurities such as leaf remnants, stem fragments, and other unwanted materials are removed using screens and suction systems. After separation, the cotton fibers are classified according to their length, color, and quality, with higher quality fibers often destined for high-end textile products. The separated cotton seeds are collected and can be used for producing cottonseed oil or animal feed. After ginning, the cotton is packed into bales, which are compact packages designed for efficient handling and transport. Each bale typically weighs 226 kilograms and can produce more than 300 dresses or over 10,000 t-shirts. Once packed and labeled, the cotton bales are loaded onto trucks and sent to textile factories, where they will be transformed into t-shirts and other garments. This is the oldest and most important yarn manufacturer in the United States. They have been making yarn for ages, and each week they produce enough to make 5 million t-shirts. Their first challenge is that t-shirt yarn requires more than just cotton. To make the yarn, clean cotton has to be mixed with rayon and polyester. The clean cotton and other fibers fall into a mixer, resembling a fibrous waterfall inside a cylinder covered with wires. This acts like a comb, sorting and aligning the fibers, and then expels spools of gray thread, known as spinning sliver, each 6,500 meters long. However, this spinning sliver is too weak and breaks easily, held together only by the cohesion of the fibers. The solution is a carding process that strengthens the yarn. The carded slivers pass through rollers that gently separate and twist the fibers, resulting in a finer but stronger yarn that is now robust enough to become thread. The yarn is wound onto spools, which are then loaded onto a giant rotating frame. Once finished, the yarn is wound onto cones, each weighing 2 kilograms. These cones embark on a 3-day, 4,000 kilometers journey across half a continent to reach the Los Angeles factory, the largest clothing producer in the United States. From this facility, more than 25 million t-shirts are sent out each year. The yarn arriving from the North Carolina factory is so fine that threading it by hand is impossible. To solve this, they use an air gun that shoots the yarn directly into the weaver. Here, 108 threads are woven into a spiderweb-like fabric, which is then transformed into a circular tube of fabric by the work of 1,620 small needles. The t-shirts produced here are available in 52 colors, so the next step is dyeing the fabric. Since the fabric is a mix of polyester, rayon, and cotton, each fiber reacts differently to dye. To solve this, the fabric is dyed in 2 separate baths at different temperatures, polyester at 130 degrees Celsius and rayon and cotton at 60 degrees Celsius. After dyeing, the fabric is placed in a giant dryer where the temperature reaches 160 degrees Celsius. To prevent the fabric from shrinking, the ends are held in a frame to maintain its shape during drying. Once dried, the fabric is bagged and ready to be turned into t-shirts. On the other side of the city, in this 74,000 square meters sewing workshop, rolls of fabric arrive at the cutting room. But before cutting, they need a pattern. Each t-shirt is made up of 6 pieces. The batch is arranged in the computer like a giant puzzle. This pattern has 1,600 pieces. Following the digital pattern, a high-speed cutter takes only minutes to cut hundreds of t-shirts from this fabric, which are then sent to the sewing area. On a busy day, the factory hums with the sound of over 3,000 machines, and each worker specializes in a specific operation. It takes a team of 13 people to make a single t-shirt, with teams paid per piece, providing an incentive for efficiency. Once assembled, each t-shirt undergoes quality control and is boxed within 2 minutes. This system ensures that the expert seamstresses become some of the highest paid workers in the world. If you want to know how silk is made, watch the video on your screen, and please like the video if you enjoyed it and share it with someone who might be interested. Also, subscribe to this channel by activating the notifications to continue learning. Thanks for watching.